Barbie movie is apparently inspiring some interesting interior design. And I'm actually for it because it involves pink. I'm a big fan of that color, bright pink to be specific. And so Barbiecore interior design has really exploded in recent months. So if you're wondering what that looks like, let's take a look at a scene from the Barbie movie featuring Margot Robbie and Ryan Gosling, which has shown off some amazing hot pink sets in the trailers for the movies, for the movie. So there you go. So when I talk about hot pink, that's what I'm referring to. And that has led to people thinking, you know what, maybe I want that maximalist hot pink interior design in my home. So we're gonna show you some examples. But first of all, what is maximalism in interior design? Maximalism experienced a resurgence in recent years as a response to the cool minimalist aesthetic that dominated Instagram feeds for so long. During the pandemic, people leaned into their personal styles at home, disco balls to handmade tiles. Cenk, how fascinated are you in this story? Scale of 1 to 10.
Look, I love the social stories. I'm near a 9 in each of them, right? Whether they're squishmallows or the buffets are back or hot pink maximalist design. Because I find humans fascinating. Mm. And so one of the questions that I have about this story is, how about the person's partner or family? Right?
Yes, that is interesting. So I want to show you a few examples of what people have done with their backyards, with their homes after being inspired by the Barbie movie. So this is the backyard of Amanda Hansen. She is a graphic designer in Washington. So you know, as you can see, she painted the stone floors or you know, stone. I forget what you call that.
Not tiles.
I'm forgetting. Anyway, she painted that hot pink. She's got the hot pink jacuzzi and all the pool accessories in hot pink as well. Another example is the following. Here's the living room of a model named Jasmine Mitchell. I think that's actually pretty tame. I mean, you can tell it's just lighting and like one piece of furniture that's hot pink. So that's not that big of a deal. But last but not least is the kitchen of a woman named Beverly Griffith. And she is not playing around. That is definitely a maximalist, hot pink Barbie inspired kitchen. So you ask a really good question, Cenk, because it's real easy to do whatever you want with your interior design. Go as bold as you want if you're living on your own or if you're lucky enough to have a partner like mine who gives you free rein to do whatever you want with interior design. But I am curious about you because you're an opinionated dude.
I am.
And so if your wife one day was like, you know what, I'm gonna go Barbiecore, how would you react to that? Would your manhood be challenged?
Well, if you put it that way, no way, man. I'll go whole, the whole house will be pink, so what? Okay, I did once have a nickname Pinky, which I can tell you about later.
Can't wait.
No, I'm okay as long as it's limited to certain number of rooms, right? And it depends on how bold you're going. So if you're the one with the neon light, that wasn't that big a deal that you said, right? I'll give you 2, 3, 4 rooms, okay, if you're going that way. The kitchen, that kitchen was real, dude. Okay, so that kitchen, you get 1, max 2 of those rooms, okay? Because if the whole house is like this, I'm just gonna have a headache. Like I can't, you can't concentrate in a house like that. It's so loud, right? But you wanna have fun and you wanna make the kitchen like that, I kinda like it. It's not for me, I wouldn't make my kitchen like that. But I like that you got the personality and the riz to do it your way, right? And I like the boldness of it and the joy of life, the joie de vivre.
Yes, yes, Jane.
Of doing it that way. So, and my daughter's gonna love it. So it's a twofer.
Okay, all right. I don't know if I would be happy if I had a partner that was opinion, like who wanted to like have a say in the interior design. I don't go crazy, right? Yeah. But it's part of the way I express myself. So I'm assuming this is part of the way that these people express themselves. The one thing, the other caveat that I think is worth mentioning is if you're renting, it's really difficult to make your rental, like the place you're renting, your own, because landlords are kind of strict about what kind of changes you can make to it. But then if you own a property and you have the freedom to do whatever you want to it, as long as you're doing it, you know, under codes and regulations, if you plan on selling that home, you're gonna have a little bit of a tough time if you've done the Barbiecore aesthetic. You get what I'm saying?
I do, and that's a choice you're making.
Yeah, that's a choice you're making.
You know that you're lowering the property value.
I'm just looking out. If it's your dream home and you plan on staying there for the rest of your life, go nuts. Do whatever you want.
Yeah, so I'm gonna say two more things about this. So one is, I'm an enormous advocate of other people doing what they want, though. So meaning, like there's some, like in Southern California where we are, Orange County, you're not allowed to go 1 inch out of the zoning. Right? Everything has to be brown, tan, gray, brown, tan, gray.
Oh, super boring.
Yeah, super boring, right? In Western LA, there's none of that. And all the houses are different. Some are small, some are big, some are modern, some are ancient, some are feels like you're in New England, the other one feels like you're in New Mexico. I love that.
Okay, but within reason, because one of the other issues about that is you'll have these cute neighborhoods. All of the houses are different, but they're relatively the same size. Yeah. They take up the same amount of lot space.
That's right.
And then some person, I'll be as kind as I can, buys one of those homes, demolishes it, and then builds a mega mansion. Right?
All the time.
And that looks so terrible. I hate that.
Nope, not buying it.
Really?
That's their business, not my business. Okay? You want to build a giant house on a tiny lot? Well, you paid for it, brother. It's up to you.
Let me ask you something. So I don't know if your backyard is private, right? But imagine you buy a home with a private backyard.
Yeah.
Some years later, a new owner buys the house next door.
Yeah.
They demolish it and build a huge house, two stories, yeah. three-story, yeah. whatever. And it has windows overlooking your backyard. How would you feel about that?
That's called life.
No, that's called hell.
No, hold on. Number one, it depends on the zoning. If you bought in an area where they're allowed to build two or three floors, then they're allowed to build two or three floors. And it is what it is. Build higher bushes, okay? I'm serious. I put in bushes and I'd put in even higher bushes. So it is what it is, and you do the make the best of it. Now, the part that would piss me off is if I bought a place with an ocean view, like any water view.
And then they build windmills.
Somebody built something on top of it and I can't see the water anymore.
Mm.
No, then we're gonna have issues. But hey, I would definitely quadruple check the zoning before I made a purchase like that, because I would think, hey, can they build a floor that blocks my view? So you get to live your life, not other people's lives. Which then brings me back to the final point I wanted to make, which is, look, so when you start cohabitating with someone, whether you're married or you're going out for a long time, and you start living in the same place, you gotta make compromises. And I will say, like, there is one compromise that I did not love, okay? And that happens, and that's normal. But you know, my wife wanted a certain aesthetic. I don't mind at all. I go nuts with aesthetic. But my leather chair didn't fit in
this. Oh God, you guys with your leather chairs.
I know, but they're so comfy.
Of course,
I love that chair.
How old was that chair?
Not that old. Not that old.
How big and bulky was that chair?
Very big and bulky.
Right, of course.
Okay, and so that was heartbreaking, okay?
God,
but
I
you compromised.
Christian had nothing when we moved in together. It was great.
So, but my point in saying that is, make more money, buy a bigger house, and let me have a room where I could put that chair with a TV.
Okay, fair. How about you make more money?
Well, yeah, I know. I'm kidding. It's not, yeah. If we could, yes, we'd all make more money and buy bigger houses and build it more floors and piss off our neighbors.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.